I think we're recording, are we? I don't know. Hello, everybody, and welcome back. We're in a FH16 Classic Volvo here, of which we've run up a fairly decent number of kilometers on. We are 79,511 reported on this screen here, actually inside the truck. However, we're still parked here, and it is 79,511 as well. Excuse me. Now, we are going to look for another job, and we're going to go straight in from our current location into our supposed dispatcher. We are located here in Geneva, and we are going to look and see what jobs we've got going on, which are greater than 200 kilometers. Paris. Jeez, I really don't want to go to Paris. No disrespect to people who are from Paris or to Paris as a city or anything, but no. We could go back with empty pallets to Milan and get €2,500 more for the job. Didn't we bring those empty pallets up here for 15,500? And then we bring them back to Milan for 17,500. That'd be a good job, wouldn't it? Maybe we should consider just going a little further and going somewhere, maybe somewhere else. This is 449 kilometers and 480 gets us up to Luxembourg, which means we're driving through a bit of France. But it gets us up a little bit out of the world. Paris, Luxembourg, Paris, Liege. Liege is 649. Well, there's no real need to do that. There isn't, is there? We could go back to Milan and see what else is going on. That'd be a bit ridiculous. Although, no, it wouldn't be a bit ridiculous. It might be the exact job that's coming up. It's completely random, and that's what we're going to do. We get paid loads of money, and we're probably already connected to it. Oh no, it's over there. Well, fair enough. Let's just take a minute here and try and understand. Gear would be a good idea. Professional driver here. You see, I know exactly what I'm doing. Oh! Into the reverse. Now, let's see if we can do this in the mirror this time, because I've been boasting how good I am at doing this, but that's with my head out the window. And if we're doing this on the mirror, are we going to be nearly as good? We're going in there fairly fast. And the answer is, not too shabby. Is it on that side that the coupling is up? Right. We have lights flashing. We're on the road. We get to go back the way we came. Bam ba dum bam, bam ba dum bam. Okay. Out we go on the way back to Milan. Now, we do have an office in Milan, which means we can fill up with fuel and all that kind of jazz, or a garage, I mean, so we can fill up with fuel when we get there. But it is practically the same job, and it'll be a good indication to understand how long it'll take us to get down there, because we spent 49 minutes in the last one on the way up. But I think some of that was downtime when I was messing with the ED tracker setup and all the rest. On this particular run, we will not have any of those issues to contend with. And hopefully we'll have no other issues to contend with either. We'll just make a run. Hopefully we won't have any stupid AI that would make me irate and get my pain and angry sounds all mixed up like I did in the last video. Don't go back to the last video to check that out, it really isn't worth it. But it was video 270, towards the end. Actually, from the garage to somewhere in the region of here is how much from the end you need to go and check that out, if you really do want to check it out, which I don't advise you do, simply because it really isn't worth it, genuinely. But I have told you the video number and the location at the end of the video that you should expect to find it. Just in case you really do want to go and check out my confusion of a painful sound with an angry sound. It's actually one of my painful sounds and one of my angry sounds. I mix them up quite a bit, you know, just to keep it fresh, you know what I mean? Yeah. Anyway, moving on. This is job number two on our quest to achieve some flags. The things you would do. It's funny. The things that we will do for something free. And this is borne out quite a bit. I was looking at some Steam statistics the other day, and I realized the thousands of people that are playing, the millions of people that play games on Steam. It's crazy. It's an amazing system, really. And there's lots of folks that are a little bit less than impressed with Steam and they don't like it because of this, that, and the other. I do wish that the developer and the Steam would have an agreement whereby the customer can turn off automatic updates once in a while. That would be something I would like, and I don't know if that's a Steam thing or if that's a developer-driven thing or if it's a mutual agreement thing, but I certainly didn't agree to it, so I'm not in that mutual agreement part. And you know, that's about my only gripe, and it's maybe incorrectly directed at Steam, but Steam is the platform that is making the functionality available, so they're in the question mark area anyway. But other than that, I'm quite a fan of Steam in most of the setup and most of the respects. I think it's matured as a tool, and when I was looking at the statistics anyway, I was noticing these ridiculous, almost ridiculous numbers. Euro Truck Simulator 2, and this was on a Wednesday, had in excess of 13,000 people playing it at 8 o'clock on Wednesday, the 8th, I guess, of June. 13,000 plus, and it had a peak during the day of a couple of thousand more. I don't remember the number. It was obviously a peak that was higher, but there was 13,000 at that instant that were playing it, or during that hour's statistics check or whatever it was. And Euro Truck Simulator 2 is a game that's been out for quite a while. Sad to report, but not too surprising, American Truck Simulator didn't report even on the top 99 games, I think, or whatever the expanded list was. It wasn't the top 10, it wasn't the top 20, maybe it was the top 50. So it didn't report on the expanded list at all. You had to dig into the detail to find how many people were playing American Truck Simulator. But 13,000 plus were playing Euro Truck Simulator. And they were down in the middle of the table, or the lower half actually, mid to lower third kind of region of this list. I think it was a list of 99 that was there, or a list of 100, but maybe it was only 50. But any case, that's not the point. At the top of the list was Dota, which is a game I don't know an awful lot about, but it's your fantasy, strategy, first-person thingy type of game, which it's a kind of game that, it's the World of Warcraft genre version. It had over 140,000 people playing it. 140,000 people playing it during the hour that statistic was being reported. So that number would fluctuate, but it was averaging 140,000 people during that hour, and it had a peak of some other crazy number during the day. I was blown away is the wrong word. I mean, I wasn't blown away to the point that it was kind of, I can't believe this, but I was not expecting those kind of numbers, I suppose, because I haven't been looking at them, and it was a little bit of an eye opener for me. I'm still in the thinking that there's only 16 people in the whole world playing games. Not quite that bad, but when you see these numbers, it kind of gives you an impression of, okay, this is what the market is, and that's those that are just playing the game. That is not those that have bought the game. Euro Truck Simulator 2 has sold over 2 million copies, and it's well on its way into 2 million whatever now. Of that 2 million, 13,000 were playing the game, although the game is a game that has been out for a good number of years. 3 years or whatever it's been out for now. Dota is a game that is relatively new from what I can make out. And so it's, you know, and it's in a genre that's probably going to have a wider customer base anyway, so you would expect the numbers to be higher. But at this rate, Dota must have sold 30 million copies, you know. But it didn't sell 30 million copies, because when I looked into it a little bit, I realized that it's a free game. Now, as I came onto the motorway, I mentioned, you know, the things we'll do for free games. Well, in a very, 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 very long-winded sense, this is what I'm tying up the loop on here. The numbers for Dota far exceeded any of the other numbers below, although the top two or three games were pretty high. But a game like Fallout was even less than Euro Truck Simulator 2. And Skyrim and Fallout were very similar to each other, somewhere around about 11,000 people. The games that were very high on the list, I'm going to say Counter-Strike something, but I might be completely off the base there. That might be just an old game that has stuck in my head. But Dota was at the top of the list with 140 whatever thousand people. But it was free. All the other games were purchase games, and they were in the high 90s and 80s. But they weren't so much. There was a big difference between them. There was quite a gulf. And it just kind of thought to me, well, it's free. That's going to attract a lot of people anyway. And people do like free stuff. And some free stuff is worth... It's really good free stuff, right? It's the loss leader that companies put out to kind of hook you to say, you know what, that was good. I think I'll buy that product because I enjoyed the free sample that I got. And Euro Truck Simulator did that. There was a kind of a free play window of time or progress level that you got to. It the demo version that they put out. I remember sitting down and playing through the demo version. And playing the demo version out to its end in one sitting, and immediately hitting buy on Steam to continue the same evening my Euro Truck Simulator driving. And, you know, a couple of careers later, and I'm 271 videos, plus all the other driving that I did. And that's including losing a career, which would have been probably 50 or 60 videos worth alone early on, which I didn't record, but I drove. So all of this has kind of come from a free sample, effectively. And free is good. Free does get you in. But free really is only of value if it has some quality to it. Free rubbish is nothing more than rubbish that you haven't paid for. And it's better than buying the rubbish, admittedly. But it's still rubbish. And I think what SES did with their demo, they put out the game as it was back then, and it's so much improved now with all of the updates that they've done, slowly, some of them, and yeah, the whole topic about SES and the speed at which they operate and the quality of the updates that they've done. The quality is no question. They've done very good updates, but the speed and the type of updates that they've done is... sometimes I have to bite my lip and just think, you know, thank God I have the game anyway, and I wish they would do other things, but, you know, reasons outside of my understanding dictate why they're happening or not happening as quickly or not as I'd like. We get the drive-through here. Oh no, that was a car. That just opened up for an invisible car. I mean, what the hell is going on? But what they did with the demo was excellent, and this little idea of the flags, essentially for no money, but you have to do something to earn it. I like that. I think that's good. I think that's... There's going to be a lot of people right now as I'm talking, doing the same thing in their game to get the required number of contract jobs recorded so that they qualify for this little giveaway. And that's getting people playing the game, which is going to be noticed on Steam. It's going to get counted in the stats, and it's going to show up in results that you know, during this particular month or during this particular week or during whatever period of time this runs for, the number of people playing was in the tens of thousands. You know, 10 or 11,000 is already a single 10 of thousand, or 10 of thousands. 13 on a Wednesday, well, you know, that might breach 20 or 25 on a weekend quite easily, right? You know, which all pays into the motivation for keeping stuff going, and it's not costing SES very much to do it. And I think it's a nice bit of clever marketing to keep a community engaged. Now, I think American Truck Simulator needs a lot of attention. And I think that was me not braking, obviously. I'm just going to push that car out of the way now. Oh, that's a bug. That car disappeared as well. Isn't it? No, he's there in front of me. He's driving away now. Be gone with you. And that's me not braking appropriately. That's all me. I apologize to that car, but they don't seem to mind. They've just gone on with themselves. There's no damage, really. I've got a €400 fine. We've got Bob taking his mum's Punto out for a spin. Way to go, Bob. Yeah. You drive it like you stole it. American Truck Simulator, yeah. Phoenix is out, and it is fantastic. Seriously, it is really a very nice DLC. It's beautifully put together, and it's really enthused the ATS community a little bit. The concern is still there, and it's not kind of a say something nice and then take something away motivated kind of comment, but there definitely is a say something nice and take something away message here. Unfortunately, it is necessary to put the context in place for this. American Truck Simulator is lacking real estate. It's lacking the map. And I'm talking about within SES. There's already mod maps out there. There's a coast-to-coast map, and there's a Mexican USA, and there's a Canada, it's Mexican and Canada kind of typed on. There's some guy who's done certain parts of Canada and done certain parts of Mexico. And then there's another guy who's done a USA coast-to-coast where he has basically taken the interstate section of the American map and put that into ATS in concert with whatever SES are producing, but I'm talking specifically about the SES map. I think it's proving to be quite a not positive reality that they released American Truck Simulator with so little. And if this was a bought into marketing strategy by SES management and the business modeling has been genuinely together based on a DLC release series that would culminate in presenting the whole of the USA, I think they went about this really the wrong way. I really do. I'm a little bit kind of concerned, and I'm concerned because I don't think the community is going to appreciate it. It's not that SES don't listen, but I think it's going to bring out every kind of argument and bad feeling a little bit, and it's going to begin to feel like a rip-off, even though in truth the quality of the DLC that represents Arizona is certainly worth some money. How much? It can't be €10. I'm sorry, it's not worth €10. But it is worth some number of euro, less than 10. Every time a new state comes out, they're charging that same price. There's 50 of them, you know, and 3 of them are out, so that leaves us 47 other states. Assuming Hawaii is not done, that's 46, so there's at least 45 plus states that we'll probably see. And if you were charging $3 or €3 or £3 per state. That's not money that people are going to spend. That they'll go mad. So I hope that that's not the plan. And of course, I don't know what SES's strategy is here. But in the absence of any formal statement from them on what the strategy is, people are going to presuppose various different things, of which one of them will be, you know, that they're going to start charging a couple of bucks per state. And, you know, a couple of bucks per state is going to get fairly close to $100, you know, dollars or euro fairly quickly. Well, it might get up to 70 or 80 in some of the currencies. And I think off the back of a game that is out at 19 bucks, that's, I don't know how that strategy is really going to work. So maybe that's actually not the strategy. But then what is the strategy? Is there a strategy? Because I hope they've actually got one. But it's just so unclear what it is. And it's this is a big concern. And it's a big concern for this reason. I'm big into trucking. No doubt about that, and I'm loving what American Truck Simulator is bringing to the community. It really is a sound piece of an experience. It's a very heavily ETS2 leveraged game. That's clear as well. There's actually room for a bit of disappointment there, to be honest with you, in that, you know, they could have done some more. They could have DX11'd it. They could have taken the big feedback components that have been within the ETS2 community forever and rolled them into American Truck Simulator and presented American Truck Simulator as the legitimate heir to the family fortune that is trucking simulators, and really consolidated the market around that. It would have been a higher cost component for them to build, but it would have charged, they could have easily charged 35, 39, 45 euro or dollars for the game and recouped their costs and kicked off a whole new series of just, you know, communities and VTCs and players across the board. The idea to leverage heavily from Euro Truck Simulator 2 wasn't necessarily a bad idea. It had lots of, and it does have lots of obvious benefits, certainly when it comes to updating two projects that are essentially founded very, very much on the same setup and the same platform. Then it simplifies the supply chain for updates and things greatly that are, you know, fundamental mechanic stuff within the game, but it's obviously no use for maps, for example. The European map and the American map are so far different that, you know, they're going to look different, but the underlying technology behind them might be common, and that can be leveraged. So, you know, there's synergies there that do make sense. However, there isn't enough of the bloody map in American Truck Simulator to keep people engaged. Euro Truck Simulator released with a hell of a lot more and was subsequently added to, not including the DLCs, and it was enhanced and improved on. The same is already happening with American Truck Simulator. California has already received a new city and some road changes and things, so that'll continue. But the physical landmass equivalent for the release of American Truck Simulator was so much less than it was apparently with Euro Truck Simulator. The people are kind of bored, which not everybody is going to do what I do and drive up and down the same road over and over again because they're simulating trucking. People have different expectations, and it's almost as if American Truck Simulator was released too early. In terms of the map, it was released too early. Yes, you have mods that come in, like the two we mentioned. And they keep the community going. But it's really important that SES get their official map in. And the mods can come along and overlay and improve and enhance on that. But their strategy is to work on states. And I think that's a mistake. I really do. I think they should work on the entire map all at once and do almost what the Coast to Coast guy has done. His name is Mandrid, I think, and he's pretty much done that all on his own. And he's put in a road structure, which is the interstate road structure across the US, the mainland North America. And he's gone ahead and built out just the road structure and put a few trees where they're needed and just filled in, you know, 100 yards on each side of the road and built up some high ground and some forestry or some rocks or whatever, and that's it, and there's nothing on the other side of the map, which there wouldn't be anyway, but that's all he's done, and there's no other roads, there's no major kind of system of smaller roads that feed into the interstate. There's just a few small towns that are put in, but they're very, very basic. But you can drive from the West Coast to the East Coast. And that's what's carrying people over. Yeah, the map is no way near as complete or as pretty or as filled out or as detailed as Arizona is now. And Arizona is amazing. It really is some of SES's best work on a map, in my opinion. And that, compared to the ability to drive from one coast to the other, is actually lacking. People want to actually drive from one coast to the other. They want that job that's going to take them 3 days to do, kind of thing. It's the sense of achievement of driving from one coast to the other that's as attractive as having a beautiful map around. So I worry that the community is not going to get caught up, which is one of the reasons I went on to look at the Steam statistics to find out how many people were playing American Truck Simulator at this point. And I easily found Euro Truck Simulator right in the middle of the table, lower half, admittedly. But I didn't even see American Truck Simulator listed, which was a little bit disappointing. I kind of felt a bit sad that it didn't even register in the... You know, I think the lower numbers were down in the 4,000 mark. So American Truck Simulator didn't... watching that car behind, and he didn't even stop. He just drove out. You'd wonder at that, wouldn't you? American Truck Simulator didn't even register 4,000. So it was less than that number. And who knows how... I didn't actually dig into the data to find out. I tried, but I didn't see any obvious link to go in to find out. Thank you very much to the red truck behind. So anyway, it's not a gripe. I'm not griping. It sounds like maybe I'm ranting a little. I'm not intending to be overcritical, but I am, for the record, putting my thoughts down into the video here on what I think the major problem with American Truck Simulator is, and I think a lot of people will agree. The other aspect is the trucks, but the trucks is a lot more of understandable. It's a lot less of an issue for me. There's a lot of folks who want, you know, different American truck models to be in the game officially, and they include Mack and they include Volvo and Internationals and whatever else. Right now we have one model or a few models of Peterbilt and a few models of Kenworth, but we don't have all the models. Like the Peterbilt 389 is the Kenworth W900 kind of equivalent, and there's a big shout for that. And the Volvo, of course, is very popular, and there's a big shout for that and all the rest. But the issue centers around apparently licensing for those, and the real issue is the concern that it's taking so long for the licensees, or the licensors, to issue a license to SES to include the trucks. Or maybe they have offered to issue a license, but you know, the costs and the conditions are prohibitive. In any case, there isn't any news on additional trucks coming in. So the community is relying heavily on the mod trucks, that some of which I assume are being ported over from ETS2 into American Truck Simulator, and some of those mods are fantastic as well, but they're mods, and as mods, they are not official. So for some people that's, you know, just an awkwardness and more of a problem, perhaps. Mods are mods, right? And every time the game updates and every time the game changes officially, then there's a big question mark over the mod every time, and that can become quite a concern, really. We need to get over here. We're not too far away from our drop zone. In fact, we're 1 kilometer away from earning our second job, which is awesome. So it is. The light is green. It's a green gate. What am I doing? Turn that off. Alrighty then, so we are literally going back to the yard that we took this out of. Whoa. My thinking here is that if SES had done the whole map at that level like this Mandrake guy has done, and then built it up layer on layer, they could still have charged some DLCs for that, but actually put more of the focus of the DLCs into other aspects of the game. Let's do it the same way, just for ease. I'm not really kind of ready for... was a challenge. Right, let's try and get this in one this time. Well, that's not going to get it in one, is it? That's just going to interrupt the trailer beside me. Do we see the windy legs going down? Oh, we do. There it is. The windy leg is on that side. It's on the other side in American Truck Simulator. How about that? Alright, so oh, no. We've frozed. No, the game is frozen. No. We have a crash, Houston. We have a crash. Euro Truck Simulator has stopped working. Goodbye. That really is a little bit sad. Sugar and spice and other words. Okay, well, not much more to say there than thanks for watching, and until the next time, go handy. No. We've gotten back in the truck here. We have a few little issues with our track IO for some reason, which seems to be doing some strange things. But let's just survive here for a minute. We do appear to be able to unload. We're lowering the trailers. We might have been able to save this. We're synchronizing with the world of trucks, and we've got the job done. Now, I went out of the game and went back into the game, and this is the situation that we have. So it does appear that we've managed to avoid losing this job, and I'm hopeful that we've actually got a second job completed within World of Trucks. So this is a little bit of extra information that's here. I am switching screens momentarily here so that I can just make a check that things are doing what they're supposed to be doing. Have I actually lost all of this? No. So it seems somehow that this is all being recorded under episode 270. Which is fine, it's just this is something that happens every so often with OBS, I think. We're in here again. And we need to zero ourselves. And I don't know why this is going odd, but we're on mouse control at the moment, which I'm not able to get out of. And I don't know why we're stuck on mouse control, but we are stuck on mouse control. And I'm wondering what the blazes is going on here. And it's all inverted. Why is this happening? In any case, we got the job done. So we're going to stop the video there and try and sort out our life after that. Thank you for watching a second time. We did save it. Two jobs down. Catch you the next time. Until then, go handy.